Xbox game development has historically been the domain of big corporate studios. But what if you, the independent developer, want to put your game in front of the millions of Xbox gamers around the globe? In this video, we're going to show you how to prepare your game, how to get approved by Microsoft, and how to set up your Xbox game development for success. This is the same process we followed while releasing games on Xbox and careers, and it's resulted in first-time concept approvals and certification passes. We are Ask Gamedev, aka the Unreal Ghostbusters, aka Rolling in Godot, aka 30 Seconds to Parse, and this is Xbox Game Development Explained. Welcome back. If you're new to Ask Gamedev, we make videos to help you learn about the games industry so that you can elevate your games and inspire others. If you're on a game dev journey, consider subscribing. We'd love to help you along the way. So you're interested in putting up your game for sale on the Xbox platform. First, let's talk about the Microsoft gaming ecosystem, because it's more than just the Xbox One. Microsoft also publishes games for its Windows 10 platform. That market is a huge install base and could also be worth your consideration. You will need to develop a Universal Windows Platform, or UWP title, if you want to access the full suite of Microsoft platforms, Xbox One, Windows 10 desktop PCs, and mobile. Microsoft sells games digitally in the Windows and Xbox One stores, and you can typically earn 70% of revenues from the sale of your game after Microsoft takes its 30% platform fee. You can also simultaneously release your title on other competing platforms beyond the Microsoft platforms, like Sony or Nintendo. If you have a particularly good game, Microsoft may be interested in offering you promotional benefits in return for having exclusive distribution on their platform for a period of time or in perpetuity. Once you have chosen the Microsoft platform you are interested in, the next thing you will want to do is establish a relationship with Microsoft by registering for an account on the ID at Xbox website. This is the hub for everything to do with publishing within the Microsoft ecosystem. Games that are approved by ID at Xbox are part of the curated offerings on the Xbox and get premium placement on the Xbox Store. Your game will have to meet the standards of quality and appropriateness. Microsoft certification means that they will stand behind your game. Once you create your account and sign an NDA, you will need to provide Microsoft with details on who you are and what you are looking to release on their platform. This includes discussing your game concept details in hopes of the approval that is necessary to release on their platforms. Once you have this, you can secure the necessary SDK, middleware, and development hardware for your needs. So, what kind of games are suitable for Microsoft platforms? The Xbox has a pretty broad offering of titles, from family-friendly games to targeted titles that include violence and other mature content. Microsoft's statement on this on the ID at Xbox website is, "While we're not trying to be censors, we're also not interested in enabling extremely vulgar, offensive, or objectionable games. In terms of content, we're looking for games that feel at home on their target platform, and that reflect what customers expect when gaming on Xbox One or Windows." So that said, when considering your game's suitability, take a peek at existing Xbox titles. Does your product vision have comparables on the platform? If so, you are probably in good shape for concept approval. On the topic of engines, the good news about developing for Xbox or Windows is that you can essentially choose from most any development engine. Most of the mainstream engine options support the Microsoft platforms. Microsoft has made official statements in the past supporting game engines like Unity, Construct 3, Monogame, and Zanko. But those are hardly the only options. You can develop in your engine of choice and be confident that your freshly authored game code will be put to good use. If you want to learn more about some of the best engines that you can use to develop your Xbox or Windows title, check out a recent video we did on engines by clicking the card above. Now, let's talk hardware and middleware for your Xbox game development. To develop for Xbox, you will typically need to secure an Xbox Development Kit. The Xbox Development Kit, or XDK for short, is a piece of hardware bundled with various software applications and is used to make games for the Xbox. It includes libraries, a compiler, and various tools to jumpstart your development. The XDK also includes a tool to record in-game footage, which has been widely used to create high-quality screenshots and trailers for the marketing of your title. Note that each approved Microsoft developer via the ID at Xbox programs gets two development kits for free. If you want to use a retail Xbox One as a development kit, you are in luck. Once you download the preview version of the Xbox Dev Mode activation app, you can unlock Dev Mode on your Xbox One and experiment with creating games. Developers in ID at Xbox have full access to the live stack and support the exact same features as all other digital content on Xbox One, including full support for multiplayer, game DVR, Kinect, in-game transactions, updates, DLC, smart glass, and more. As Microsoft says, if a feature is supported on Xbox One, ID at Xbox games can take advantage of it. Once your development is complete, you will want to submit your title for final certification. This is where Microsoft ensures that your game is of high quality and won't break or behave inappropriately. For Xbox One titles, you will be provided a release manager who will help you navigate the certification process, including clear documentation on certification requirements, such as acquiring ESRB or other ratings. For the Xbox, make sure to allot time to read over all of the certification guidelines and then allow for more time to execute on them. You're going to need to support countless scenarios, including usage of the Xbox hardware and controllers. What happens to your game when an Xbox controller is pulled out? You will need a plan for that. You will also need to support platform standards for front-end and pause menus, including making sure your game provides users with the same standardized usage messaging as other Xbox games. How long should you allocate for the whole certification process? It somewhat depends on how done your final build is when you submit it. If you have done a thorough job meeting all of the Xbox requirements, you could get a first-time pass through certification in a few weeks. The timeline could be much longer if you have to resubmit builds as a result of a lot of certification holes. The best thing to do is talk with your representative at ID at Xbox to get an understanding of the latest timeline estimates. For Windows games, the certification process is much quicker, with less stringent requirements around bugs and user notifications. Now that we have covered ID at Xbox, there is another option with the Xbox platforms that has less approval and certification requirements, and that's the Xbox Live Creators Program. Whether you're just getting into game development, finishing a student project, or looking to take your latest creation to the biggest screen in the house, the Xbox Live Creators Program is for you. Games from the Creators Program can be found in the Creators Collection, a special section of the Xbox One store. To get into the Creators Collection, your game will need to integrate Xbox Live and follow the standard store policies. No concept approval is required. This is a marketplace for unfiltered games directly from the developers themselves, so user feedback drives how Creators Collection games are rated. So what's the catch? Well, for one, your title won't get access to all of the Xbox game development services. While many services like leaderboards, cloud saves, game hubs, clubs, party chat, and mixer broadcasting are supported, you won't get access to achievements, game score, or internet multiplayer. To access those features, developers will need to go through the ID at Xbox program. Also, creators program accounts cost approximately $19 US, and company accounts cost approximately $99 US, and the exact amounts may vary depending on your country or region. This is a one-time registration fee and no renewal is required. A developer account lets you submit apps and add-ins to the Microsoft marketplaces. Fun games like Solitaire HD, Space Cat, and Whispers in the Dark have all had success with the Creators Program. Check out the Xbox Live Creators Program site for more details. So now you are ready to jumpstart your Xbox game development. This is the second video in our platform series. We recently covered publishing on the Nintendo Switch, so check out that video by clicking the card above. Also, we would like to know what you think is the most attractive console to develop for. Maybe it's the Xbox One, or maybe it's one of the Nintendo or Sony platforms. Either way, let your fellow viewers know your opinion on the best platforms for developers in the comments below. We'll leave you now with a look at a game made by a fellow member of the Ask Gamedev community, Bracer Jack, who owns the Bracer Jack channel here on YouTube. The title is called SNU and was built by a single developer from start to finish in only 1 year. Very inspiring. SNU is available on iOS for free and see our video description for the link to check it out. If you're on a game dev journey, please link your game, art, animation, or audio in the comments below as we're looking to celebrate more viewer projects in future videos. Thanks for watching. We are Ask Gamedev and we make videos on games, the game industry, and more. We publish new content every week on how to elevate your games, so consider subscribing. And hit the bell below to be notified as soon as a new video is available.